important points to be remembered are, first, summation x is equal to 0 to n px is equal to summation x is equal to 0 to n px is our ncx p to the power x into q to the power n minus x. It will be nothing but q plus p whole power n. It means 1 to the power n, this is equal to 1. Since q plus p equal to 1, since it is our probability mass function, therefore we have taken it as summation sign. For a continuous case, we will take integration sign. Next, each trial results in two mutually disjoint outcomes, termed as success and failure. We will take only those cases where we have two outcomes. First, we will call as success and another we will call it failure. And third, the number of trials n is finite. Total number of trials in an experiment will be finite. For a finite case, we are taking this binomial distribution. The trials are independent of each other. Each trial is independent of another trial. Fifth, the probability of success p, small p, is constant for each trial. For each trial, we have this small p as a constant. Now, a question for the practice. There are two players A and B. Capital A and B, they play a game. They are playing a game. In this game, in which their chances of winning are in the ratio 3:2. A's chance of winning and B's chance of winning, they are in the ratio of 3:2. So A's chance is probability that A wins will be 3/5 and probability that B wins will be 2/5. We need to find A's chance of winning at least 3 games out of the 5 games played. A and B both plays 5 games and A wins 3 games, 4 games, 5 games. We need to find at least 3 games which A wins. It means A will win either 3 game or 4 game or 5 game. Here we have, I am giving one hint, that is n is equal to 5, means total number of trials 5, with the probability of success or probability of A is winning is 3/5 and Q will be our 2/5. So we need to find the probability that x is greater than or equal to 3, means probability x equal to 3 plus probability x equal to 4 plus probability x equal to 5. Solve this.